Let me show you a WinDBG HangDump. Applications sometimes hang. When that happens, you get the dreaded not responding message. The screen fades out and the program stops responding to all mouse clicks and keyboard input. The window has stopped drawing because it's not pumping window messages. First, a quick primer on message pumping. This is gonna be the simplest explanation, but generally Windows applications work this way. Windows applications, when run in a message loop. The loop processes messages which are pumped in by the operating system. The draw message is the most important message because it is the message that draws itself. When that message is not pumped, that is how Windows knows that the application has hung. Failure to pump the draw message is what Windows uses to indicate that the process is not responding. That is why when you see a not responding dialog, the window stops drawing. And often, if you click buttons or you try to move the window around, it doesn't move. That's because it's not drawing itself. This creates a problem when capturing a memory dump when the program is hung. The core issue is that in order to attach the debugger to a process, a remote thread is created. This remote thread is then used to actually write the memory dump to disk. If the process has hung, creating the remote thread is difficult because the message pumper may not be running. If the message pump is not running, the remote thread cannot be created. So this means that WinDBG or any other debugger may actually hang while trying to attach to the process. So to capture a hang dump, the debugger must not really attach to the process. WinDBG has a mode for this. It's called a non-invasive attach. Basically, WinDBG will not create a remote thread when attaching non-invasively. Let me switch real quickly to an application that I wrote that can simulate a hang. Basically, this application, what it does is, if I click on the lock button and then I click on the hang button, it will actually hang the application. I've written this application specifically to capture the memory dump of a hang dump. I'll put the source code in the description below, but any application that hangs can be the sample to test WinDBG on a hang dump. So let me go ahead and hang the application. I'm going to click lock and then I'm going to click hang. And what will happen is now the application has hung. It will stop drawing. The hang button will basically just remain there and I won't be able to click any other button because the program is hung. I'll use WinDBG and capture the hang dump. Okay, let me switch real quick to WinDBG. So I have WinDBG open. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to attach to process. I'm going to choose the process that I want. It's called hangapp1.exe. Very simple name. What I'm going to do is for the attach button, I'm not going to click attach because it's a hang dump. Now, it might be able to attach properly, but I'm going to show you what to do if you have a hang dump that's not pumping messages at all. So what you do is you click on this drop down and you choose non-invasive attach. Now that WinDBG has kind of attached to the process non-invasively, what exactly happened is that WinDBG suspended all the threads and it just attached to the process. It did not create the remote thread and it's kind of different. So what we can do is, if we view threads by just running the thread command, which is the tilde, we see that there is one thread and it is suspended. The suspend count over here, which is 1 in this case, has meaning. If a thread suspend count is above 0, that thread will not run. The operating system will skip that thread whenever it's choosing a thread to run for the process. If all the threads are suspended that way, then the process will not run any thread. Frozen is a state where the debugger can kind of like, it can stop a thread, but it does not change the suspend count. I generally don't mess around with the frozen and unfrozen state. not really important for this debugging tutorial. But for the suspend state, it does make a difference. If the suspend state is zero or less, that means the trade is eligible to run. At this point, what we want to do is we want to resume all the trades because we know that WinDBG, when it non-invasively attached, it suspended all the trades. So what we do is we put tilde asterisk M. So tilde is trade, asterisk is all trades, and M means resume. So if we do that one time and we look at the trade, we see that the suspend count is now zero. The trade is eligible to run. And the reason we want to do that is because if this hang is not real, the process will immediately start again and it will continue running. In this case, because I have made sure that this process has truly hung, even though it is suspend zero, this trade is not going to run. Now that we have all the trades running again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a memory dump by using the dump command, put slash ma, which is mini dump all, and give it a path. I'm just going to call it dmp1.dmp. You can choose any path you want, and the dump will be written to disk. Okay, let me just kill the application by stop debugging. Now, generally, you will just detach from the application and try to close it, but I'm just going to kill it so that I can get to the hang dump. I'm going to open the hang dump. I'm just going to go to open dump file. There we are, dmp1.dmp. I'm just going to open it. And there we are, the hang dump is open. Now that the hang dump is open, you need to load symbols. So on my system, all the Microsoft symbols have already been configured. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to run sympath one time and I'm going to add a folder. And this folder is the folder to the symbols for this particular application. If you have a more complicated application or you have symbols loaded elsewhere, just load your symbols now. You can use any folder. If you need help loading symbols, I have another video in this playlist all about loading symbols. Go ahead, watch that. But all you gotta do is make sure you load symbols because all the commands from here onwards, if you have symbols, they will load properly. If you don't have symbols, then the stacks will not look good and you may not be able to find out the reason why there is a hang. Now that the symbols are ready, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run tilde asterisk k. What this does is that it dumps out all the stacks of all the threads. Now, generally, if you run this command, it's going to be really, really slow. But what I did was I made sure that this particular application only had one thread. If your application has a lot of threads, this command might be really slow. So just be patient while it's downloading symbols and dumping out all the stacks. But this is a very good point to do because you want to look at all the stacks to see what's happening and most likely to try to spot why is the messages not being pumped on thread zero. Okay, on my machine, the dump has completed. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to scroll up. So because this dump only has one thread, yeah, it was pretty easy to know why it hang. So I'm just going to go from the bottom. So RTL user thread start. Yep, that's the start of the thread. Main, this is my main thread. This is thread zero. I can see it down here. This is thread zero. And this is an MFC application and I can see that it is pumping messages. But if I look at the top of the stack over here, what I see is that I see a wait for single object. And what this does is this wait for single object is waiting for a event to be signaled. Now, wait for single object means wait for a handle. It could be an event, it could be a semaphore, it could be a mutex, it could be one of many things. And if the event is not signaled, this thread essentially will wait forever. So what I've done is I've actually made an event and I've actually said that it is unsignaled. So that is why this thread stopped. So let's take a look at that event. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run KB. And what KB does is that it shows me the arguments to the functions. So if I look for wait for single object EX, I see that the first argument is the number 1F0. This is the handle to the event. So if I take that address and I do handle with a number in there, and I put an F at the back, this shows me all the information about that handle. So if I press enter, what I'll get is, I'll get that this handle is a semaphore, yep, and I'll get that the handle count is 2. That means that this event is unsignaled, meaning that if we wait for this event, the wait for single object will essentially wait there. And if I look at wait for single object up here, I see that the second parameter is all Fs. This means that I have put wait infinite. And this is the reason why this thread has hung. Basically, if this event over here, if this semaphore, if the handle count does not return back to 0, this thread will be stuck forever. Now, if I did not artificially create this memory dump, I probably would not know what created the hang. If that's the case, looking at all the handles is really difficult. One of the simple technique you can do is to use a plugin to actually search the memory to try to find why it has hung. There is one such command called logs. What this command does is that it searches all the critical sections to try to find if there is any threads that are waiting on critical sections and causing the hang. Now, a lot of these commands are really sophisticated and I don't want to make this video very long. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to end this video just by showing one simple technique just to look at the handle. And I'll make another video after this dedicated to critical section locks, and probably another one after that dedicated to re-entrant locks. So anyway, let me just switch back to full screen. So anyway, looking for locks and looking for why the thread hung is not really that simple, and there are a few commands that can help you out, but it is mostly just looking at the top of the stack, looking for the function at the top of the stack, like why it has stopped pumping messages, and trying to find the event or the mutex or the critical section, trying to find why the event is not signaled. Hang dumps are actually the same as crash dumps. They're basically the same. The only difference is that when you capture a hang dump, you just gotta be vigilant that if it's not pumping messages, you need to attach non-invasively. If it is pumping messages, you can just attach WinDBG and take it as a crash dump. But just remember that if it is a hang dump, look at the threads. If the threads are suspended, then resume them and then capture the memory dump. If you capture the memory dump when all the threads are suspended, you might have just hung it yourself by attaching WinDBG. So just remember, if you attach non-invasively, you gotta resume the threads. So anyway, I think the video is long enough. I think I'll just end it right here. I'll make another video for lock re-entrancy and critical sections and maybe a few other kinds of variants of locks. But basically the technique is nearly the same. Just look at all the stacks and just try to pick the handles that are causing the threads to stop. So before I do that, a gentle reminder to subscribe, hit that bell icon. That actually lets me know what kind of videos to make, and that really lets me know that which direction I should be going if I make more WinDBG videos. So definitely, if you have time, please hit that subscribe, hit that bell icon, give me a like if you want to. You can subscribe now. If you don't like it, you can always unsubscribe later. As always, it's been a pleasure bringing you this information. I'm High Voice, signing out.